Psycho, North by Northwest, The Birds, and The Rear Window. These are classics from the world film history. We should have definitely heard these names once in our lifetime. And Alfred Hitchcock, who was one of the most successful film directors of all the times, have made them. Welcome to our video essay, which is related about Alfred Hitchcock. Hitchcock, who was born in London in August 13, 1899, and studied engineering, he is known for his classic films such as Psycho, North by Northwest, Vertigo, Rear Window, and The Birds. He is considered to be one of the finest directors of all time. Alfred Hitchcock was born on August 13, 1899 in Leytonstone, England, East London. Hitchcock spent his childhood in his family's grocery store. Raised as a dark Catholic, Hitchcock studied at the Jesuit School of Ignatius College in London.
Hitchcock developed a lifelong interest in the subject of guilt, which was further developed in St. Ignatius College.
Although Hitchcock says, "For me, my films are more important than any assessment of morality," the themes of sin, guilt, punishment, and regret are the main elements of his films.
In this video essay, we are going to talk about the most influential movies of Hitchcock, which is The Psycho and The Rear Window. We are going to analyze the elements that the film and Hitchcock wants to give the audience as a message. What is Rear Window? What made this film so special?
In the movie, Jeffries breaks his leg as a result of an accident, and as he can't be able to move, he starts to watch his neighbors. In other words, he does voyeurism from his window and witness lots of things about them and suspect about a crime and investigate them. In the film, there is a criticism towards the classic Hollywood movie team and the audience. Neighbors are like a part of Hollywood system. Neighbors live in New York's wealthy apartments, and they all have interest about art, which can be seen in Hollywood studios. Okay, what is voyeurism? It means that the person being watched is unaware of being monitored, and monitoring gives pleasure to him. Jeffries are like the facts of the Hollywood. He has a godlike power as he watches them, sitting down in his couch like the audience did in cinema. His cinema movement indicates what we are looking at. He makes the movie flow.
When Thorvald notices him, voyeurism ends, and it's like an emphasis on the cinema audience. Hitchcock says to us is that if we continue to be a cinema audience with a pleasure, you'll soon become like Jeffries, you'll stick on your couch and can't understand the real meaning of the art of the cinema.
We also shouldn't forget to mention the one of the most unforgettable movies of all time before we finish.
This is Alfred Hitchcock. Having lived with Psycho since it was a gleam in my camera's eye.
Psycho in 1960 was Hitchcock's most terrifying and controversial film, and its most famous scene made an entire generation of moviegoers nervous about taking a shower. The events in the movie starts with when Marion have $40,000 by his patron. She goes to a motel, and the owner of the hotel, Norman, invites her to his home where his old and ill mother lives in. And then she suddenly appears and kills her. When a man comes to investigation, he dies. And the fact is that his mother actually died many years ago, and Norman is a schizophrenic person who has two personalities.
Hitchcock, in his many interviews, he says, "Psycho was made for love. It's a funny film. And people think he has a weird sense of entertainment."
And now we will count some Freudian ideas in the movie. The audience is constantly asked who is the killer throughout the movie. Mirror is a reckoning. Ego, superego relationship. Entrance floor is ego. Norman is a normal person, but her mother's room is superego. The name Norman comes from normal. Purity is shown with her white underwear, but later it turns black.
Nearly the whole film was shot with 50mm lenses on 35mm cameras.
In this perspective, the view become like human vision.
77 different camera angles were used during the shower scenes.
And we can see some extreme close-ups in the movie. Both of his films is a proof that he was really a legend that will inspire lots of directors in the future.